How was this process?
No, this process, I must say that it was well accommodated by everybody in government as well. When we met up with the government, they were very appreciative that we have come with this kind of help. What we are trying to do is to make sure that probably by the end of this year, or latest first quarter of next year, each and every Mosotho in the country is vaccinated against this pandemic.
Business has been worst affected since the beginning of the pandemic, and Matekane knows this too well.
This has been a disaster for business, and we are praying that this thing, the sooner it gets out of our way, so that we can be able to get our back to our normal lives and move on. Business survived because of the people around it. If there's no people, there's no business. Then. So we have to make sure that our people survive.
Lesotho is aiming at utilizing the high-end tracking technology during the vaccine rollout.
We will be the first country to do that, to digitally verify the vaccine. If we are talking about a two-dose vaccine, your first dose and 21 days later, if we are talking about Pfizer, Olanga in exactly the prescribed time. So it means you are properly inoculated.
Pafani is appealing for men and women of goodwill to help achieve the ultimate target of 1.1 million jobs to citizens by the end of this year or early next year.
This fund is for the people. Yes, business may be leading it, but this is for every Mosotho here at home and abroad. We take any amount of donations because we want the people, our people, to rally behind this and to really try and get back to normal.
Lesotho has only received 38,000 doses of the AstraZeneca vaccine through a COVAX initiative. While plans to inoculate at least two-thirds of the slightly over 2 million population size, a group of businessmen and women have formed a solidarity fund called sesiu, loosely translated to mean that it takes a crowd to wrestle a bull. I'm Rapelang Radebe, SABC News, Maseru, Lesotho.